showed everybody part one of the segment of building the 6.2 Trackhawk Hellcat engine. We kind of explained the parts. We used the Ross pistons. They're hard anodized, a little bit higher compression than stock. We used the Carrillo rod. With that whole assembly, it ended up being really lightweight. And what I'm told from the engine guys was this thing was a piece of cake to balance. It's nice to hear. Obviously, the lighter rotating assembly is a lot better for ET at the track, accelerates faster, just a whole better combination. We went ahead and honed this block with plates. We deburred it. Pretty much every engine that comes out of Livernois is deburred. It's kind of automatic now. We also put in the oil squirters that this factory engine retained. It's important to keep that oil squirter in there. Cools the piston. It's the right thing to do. A lot of guys just ditch them. It's too much work. I said, no way, we got to keep them. But anyway, we also coated the pistons. We used our proprietary coating. We do coat the skirts. We don't coat the top. It's not necessary with a hard anodized piston. We gap the rings. We used a total seal gapless. That's the right thing to do in this engine. It's kind of like our Stage 3 engine, a better deal. Anyway, we detailed and recorded all of our engine specs. Like the old school guys remember that as blueprinting and balancing. So we did do that. Bruce is right now finishing the engine. It's pretty much a complete short block at this point. Degreeing the camshaft in. We did make sure we kept a VVT. It's important to degree it in. Even though the engine will move it around, we want to make sure it's perfect. But anyway, stay tuned for, we're going to put the heads on this thing, put it in the car, and make some power poles, and we'll let everybody know what kind of power this thing made. Anyway, thanks for watching.